And there you have the federal debt, $609 billion and growing, $17,388.17 for every man, woman, and child. This is one of the reasons we need to cut spending. Instead, the federal government has decided times are tough. They'll boost fees on law-abiding gun owners, and they're also increasing tariffs on tons of products, including firearms. Mike Moffat is a university professor in economics at Western Ontario, and he's been digging through this tariff code. And Mike, I got to hand it to you. That is a massive task that you're undertaking. But you found that there's a big tariff hike coming for a lot of firearms.
Yeah, I was a little surprised by it. So there's tariff hikes coming on 1,300 classes of goods, so everything from bicycles to baby strollers. And digging through this, that I found that basically every single class of firearms, the tariff is increasing. So everything from pistols to rifles to shotguns to their parts.
Now
we're seeing the tariffs go up.
Yeah, so these are the tariffs that we're talking about, but these are not for every country. So if you're importing from the U.S., it's not going up. But those tend to be the high-end ones. These tariffs are going up, you tell me, on mostly low-end, very affordable firearms?
Yeah, that's right. So the U.S. is covered under NAFTA, so there's no tariff increases there. But Turkey, Brazil, India, China, we import a great deal of firearms from these countries. So Turkey's our third largest importer of shotguns, for instance. So other than some Russian arms that are affected by this, that this is more sort of the affordable type of, you know, a 22 or something like that, that you might give to your teenage son. So this isn't really the high-end stuff. It's more the lower-end, entry-level product.
And sometimes the knockoffs, I was looking before we came on air, there's a very popular pistol. It's been around for just over a century now, the 1911. If you go with a popular manufacturer like SIG, you're paying about $1,000 or more for that. You go with the Norinco from China, and it's about $350, but that's going to go up. It's still going to be cheaper, but the government's going to get their take.
Yeah, exactly. So they're raising tariffs by about 4 to 7%. So right now these goods come in tariff-free. It's a 0% tariff. Now, depending on, you know, what type of gun, the caliber, the tax is going to be anywhere from about 3.5% to 7%. So, yeah, it's definitely going to make these items more expensive.
I love you. You've been tweeting about this, blogging about it. You even tweeted about coffins going up. That's how wide-ranging. Bicycles, tricycles, coffins, guns, all of these things are going up. You're getting the NDP to be demanding lower taxes. They're denouncing this as a giant tax hike. I'm quite like this NDP saying that they don't like tax hikes. As an economist, are tariffs an effective way of raising revenue or dealing with economic issues?
No, because they distort the market. That basically now, let's look at the 1911 pistol example. Then now we're raising the price on some items but not others, so that distorts consumer choices. And as well, there's a lot of paperwork that, to import these goods, now you're filling out all this paperwork and paying these tariffs to the government. So it's not a very efficient way of collecting tax revenue, and it just increases the burden on Canadian importers.
So what's the point of doing this then? The Harper government said, look, a lot of these countries had preferential treatment because they were developing countries. Now they're not. I don't think we could really consider Brazil or China to be developing countries. And they said, we've got tariffs on goods from other countries that are our major trading partners. So why not these guys? Is that a fair argument?
Well, there is something to that. So German imports, if you import a gun from Germany or Switzerland, it currently pays these tariffs. So there's an argument you can make for harmonization, but there's two ways to harmonize. I mean, you could bring the high tariffs down low, or you can bring the low tariffs up high. So what the government's done is they've harmonized by basically raising everybody's taxes so there's high tariffs across the board.
I know that in some cases tariffs have been around to protect the bicycle industry, and there's very few bikes made in Canada, but there's a couple of places where it's still done. There's not really a whole lot of firearms. I don't know what the domestic coffin industry is like, but is that still play a role in it, protecting domestic industry?
Well, I think initially it did. And a lot of these tariffs, you know, go back to the 1960s and 1970s when Canada actually manufactured these items, such as coffee makers. which is one of the items where tariffs is going up. Now we don't really anymore. So it's this sort of legacy tax for industries that existed 40 years ago that don't. And it actually, in fact, hurts Canadian businesses because now Canadian retailers in places like Niagara Falls and Vancouver and Windsor have to compete against U.S. retailers. Well, now, you know, we're Canadian retailers are paying this higher tax. American retailers aren't. So it's just going to increase cross-border shopping. So it actually hurts Canadian businesses more than it helps.
All right, Mike Moffat, thanks for joining us today, and thanks for going through that tariff code.
Well, thank you for having me.
All right, send me your thoughts, byline @sunmedia.ca. Stick around, we're not done yet.